Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you here today. I'm Kate Hetherington, president of Howard Community College, and thank you for joining us in our groundbreaking ceremony at what will become Howard Community College's newest building, the Science, Engineering, and Technology Building. Yes! Woo! And while we're standing on asphalt right now, within 2 years, this parking lot will be transformed into an amazing 145,000 square foot, four-story facility that will educate and train the next generation of biologists, doctors, engineers, cybersecurity technicians, chemists, and much more. The students in this building will go on to meet the dynamic science, engineering, and technology workforce demands of Howard County and the state of Maryland. All right. Not only do we have students that know STEM, but they can catch things too. That's good. So today's groundbreaking would not have been possible without the support of our elected officials from the county and state, and our board chair, Skip Cole. We'll introduce each of the elected officials individually, but I wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you. Thank you very much for all the good work that you've done. The $76 million building is being financed 50% by Howard County and 50% by the state, so we appreciate that. And thank you to all the taxpayers in our county and state. That's where the money comes from, folks. So thank you for that. And what will be the new building? What will it look like? Well, as long as it doesn't blow away, I urge you to take a closer look at the drawings by the podium, and they'll demonstrate what the science, engineering, and technology building will look like when it's finished. Okay, things are rolling here. All right. On every floor, you'll find spaces that invite students to connect and collaborate, to study, and to make newfound discoveries. There are classrooms and labs, and there also is an undergraduate research lab, which is new for us here at the college, 3D printing, which we've had, but we'll have a new space for it, and a fab lab, a drop zone to test physics and science experiments, an outdoor learning classroom, and a community room. You'll also find a greenhouse and a rooftop observatory. Every single space will inspire learning. But the building is only a building. It must be filled with faculty and staff who will encourage and engage students along their pathway to success. Thank you to our incredible, our talented, our innovative faculty and staff for joining us and for the work that you do every day to support our students. While this building is still a couple of years away before opening its doors, there's already many individuals who have been instrumental in helping HCC get to this point. It's been a pleasure to work on this incredible project with Air St. Gross and the team of consultants. In particular, I'd like to recognize Ed Coles, principal, and Corey Chang, project manager. Please raise your hand. I know you are here. Thank you for your good work. I also see my running buddy, Scott Beath, here. Hello, Scott, from Air St. Gross. The team that is ready to start construction very soon, Gilbane Building Company. We have Justin Perkoski, project manager, with us today. There he is. Thank you, Justin. Thank you. We look forward to continuing to work with you. And a sincere thank you to all the members of the HCC faculty and staff who worked on this building. Please wave your hand and be recognized. I'm going to name a few people specifically from the finance and administration area, led by Vice President Lynn Coleman. I'd like to give a special acknowledgement to Travis Hopkins, facilities planner, Chuck Nightingale, executive director of capital project and facilities, Shelley Bellella, capital programs administrator. Also from the college, I'd like from the academic affairs area, led by Vice President Dr. Sharon Pierce, I'd like to acknowledge Patty Turner and her team from the Science, Engineering, and Technology Division, who have collaborated with everyone here to ensure our students will have the best possible learning environment. Please give these hardworking folks a round of applause. I also like to take a moment to highlight some other special friends in the audience. Our Howard Community College Educational Foundation Board of Directors, who are committed to raising funds, supporting student scholarships, programs, and facilities. Would you please wave your hand and be recognized? Thank you all for being here. As our building starts to take shape, we have many naming opportunities. This is where our foundation board will be put to work. And a great investment, because you can get a naming opportunity and then direct that money to scholarship funds. So two for one. We got a great deal going here, folks. So we are excited about the naming opportunities and our development office. You can contact them for more information. And now I have the pleasure of introducing Skip Cole, chair of our Board of Trustees, who will introduce the members of our board and our elected officials. And before I move on to Skip, I want to thank Skip for his leadership and all the members of our Board of Trustees. They do an incredible job serving the college, governing the college, and we couldn't do what we do without their support. So let's give a round of applause for our Board of Trustees.
Thank you, Kate. I am so pleased to be here this morning with the trustees, the students, faculty and staff of HCC, as well as our elected officials and dear friends, and our supporters. I'd like to take a moment to welcome and recognize my fellow trustees who are with us today. We have Bobby Dillo, Kevin Doyle, Kathy Ruskin. Thank you. We are excited about today's groundbreaking and the new future for science, engineering, and technology education for our students and community. I would like to take a few moments to recognize our elected officials who are with us today and have been instrumental in making today possible. Their support at both the county and state levels have been invaluable. Please join me to thank those who are with us today. Howard County Vice Chair Courtney Watson. Howard County Council Members Jen Teresa and Mary Kay Sigaty. From the Howard County Delegation of the Maryland General Assembly, we are pleased to thank Howard County Delegation Chair, Delegate Frank Turner, Senator and County Executive-Elect Alan Kittleman, Delegate and Senator-Elect Guy Gazzone, Delegate and Senator-Elect Gail Bates, Delegate Elizabeth Bobo, Delegate Steve DuBois, Delegate James Malone, he didn't make it. Delegate Warren Miller, and Delegate representing Shane Bendergus, or representing Delegate Shane Bendergus, Virginia Charles, and Delegate-Elect Trent Kittleman. I also want to recognize several of our incoming elected officials who have joined us today. Howard County Councilmember-elect John Weinstein. Delegate-elect Vanessa Atterbury. Delegate-elect Eric Ebersole. No, Eric. Delegate-elect Terry Hill. Delegate-elect Clarence Lamb. And again, Delegate-elect Trent Kittleman. We're very excited there. Okay. Together, the county and state have provided a much-needed support for the design and initial funding for the construction of the future science, engineering, and technology building. We cannot thank you enough for your investment in the college and for recognizing the critical need for the state-of-the-art facility to educate our community's future STEM professionals. With the increasing demand for well-trained STEM professionals, this building will ensure that students leave our doors prepared not only for jobs of today, but also for those of tomorrow. Once again, thank you for supporting the work we do. I'd now like to take a few moments to introduce our next speaker. First, County Council Vice Chair Courtney Watson will speak, followed by Chairman of the Howard County Delegation, the Honorable Frank Turner, and then State Senator, County Executive-Elect, Alan Kittleman. Please join me in welcoming County Council Vice Chair Courtney Watson to the podium.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. It is really a pleasure to be here representing the Howard County Council. And as we were thinking about this STEM building, one of our researchers thought to mention that it was really in the 1950s when the Russians launched Sputnik that America spurred its educational system to advance education in math and science. That's where STEM really started in our educational system back in the 1950s, but it waxed and waned over the century. With the predominance of technology now in every aspect of our lives, the advancement in technology and the global economy, we have realized that once again, we have to make science, engineering, and technology a high priority in our educational system. And so Howard County, as you heard before, has appropriated over $24 million to date that is shared approximately equally between the state and the county. And we know for all of the elected officials who are going to serve after December 1 and January 21st that it will require another $50 million to complete this building. And I know that we're going to count on our foundation and our community members to raise funds, and we'll also count on our state and county to make sure that we get this building fully funded. And that's the one good thing we can say is that there is no real better investment in Howard County for our dollars than in the community college, because it touches every aspect of our society and helps people be trained and ready for the workforce. And so it is not a partisan investment. It is a very important investment that all parties support, and I'm glad to be part of that. And so on behalf of the Howard County Council, we are very excited to be a funder in this initiative, and we wish the college and this building the very best.
Well, good morning, and I'm going to keep this short because I don't want my whole delegation to start off mad with me. But you know, this today is about the students, and it's really an investment in the future, in the future generations of students who will really move this country forward. And that's why we're here today. It's all about there. But you know, if we go back 20 years and we look at, you know, I think about, you know, this campus 20 years ago when I was first elected, man, that Rouse Cup, the Student Center wasn't there, the Duncan Building wasn't there, the Health Science Building there. And you drive on campus and you drove into this parking lot. And it was not only a parking lot, it was a parking lot that was down in a valley. So it was really, you know, you look around with the new addition of this new building today, it's such an exciting time, and it's such an exciting campus now. You know, I always tell people when I'm out there, this is really the Harvard of community colleges. and they say, yeah, this is the primary and one of the best community colleges in the entire nation. You know, I got it wrong the first three times. I sent my first kid to a private school. Oh, boy, did that cost me. I have a problem. And then the next one I sent to a four-year institution. A state school, was getting smarter. It took me three times to realize, hey, the rest of you are going to community college, and you're going to Howard too. Tell me where you're going. So it took me, you know, I hope the rest of you don't take that much time to get it right. Well, I just want to say on behalf of the delegation how proud we are that this building is coming up. And we're going to work hard in Annapolis to make sure that we have funding. You know, just one last quick story. When I was chairman of the education subcommittee, we used to make the community colleges sit there all day and listen to the four-year colleges come in with projects like the Fine Arts Building. It's a great Fine Arts Building at the University of Maryland. That's a $140 million project. And they'd have to sit there and listen to school after school after school. Well, guess what? When I was chairman, I put the community college first. Because I didn't want them to hear how they have to split up. What was it, 40? No, it's,
we have 86 million.
Well, now it's 86, but then it was like $40 million among 16, you know, community colleges. Absolutely horrible. But, you know, at least we did that for the time I was there. I just didn't want them to hear all those projects that were getting funded for 4 years. But thank you, and appreciate you allowing me to say some words on behalf of the delegation. On behalf of the delegation, we thank you for all of your hard work. And we're going to work hard to make sure we can get the funding that you need to build this building and get that other $50 million. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll try to be even more brief because my former colleagues in the Senate and the House will be upset at me. I think it's a good bridge here since I am currently a senator and a state legislator. In less than three weeks, I will be a county official. So it's a good way to bridge. And I know Courtney and I, having lived here all our lives, remember, Frank, when it was even just one building here. And I remember my sister came here when she actually graduated from Athelton. And I am a proud father of a graduate of HCC. My daughter graduated from here last year. She's now at College Park. So thank you very much for the education you provide to my daughter. And she's doing well down in College Park. So I just want to say thank you. I'm glad that this is a cooperative effort between the state and the county. And I pledge to continue to do that with my colleagues on the county council. I know we can work well together to try to make sure that we can continue to fund this project. There's no question this is the a gem of Howard County. When I'm down in Annapolis, and I think my colleagues can confirm this, when we have the Howard Community College come down with the other community colleges, everybody just comes to us and goes, wow, you guys are lucky because you have Howard Community College. And everybody wishes they could have this in their county. And you know what? We have the best one because we have the best leader, Kate Hetherington, and the best board of trustees, and the Educational Foundation. So that's all you need to hear from me. Let's go move some dirt.
Thank you to our elected officials. Thank you, Courtney, Frank, and Alan. You're always so supportive of the college, and we appreciate your kind remarks. And as Alan said, let's move some dirt. So I have the distinct pleasure of inviting all our elected officials to the sandbox to take the first ceremony dig along with our Board of Trustees members.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, dig!